Let's talk about some interesting questions that will help us revise analytical functions with key focus on window functions. If you are not comfortable with analytical functions, I have a video on it. I will recommend that you watch it first. You will see a link to it on the top of your screen. If you want me to create another video on it with more interesting scenarios, please drop in a comment and I will start working on it. But if you understand max over partition by, order by, rows between, unbounded, following well enough, give these queries a shot and post your answers in the comment section. I will explain the entire concept in detail with the solution to these queries in the next video. So for the first one, we have a table with these three columns listing the sales of individual products. We need to come up with a query which will have an additional column listing the contribution of the respective product sales to the overall sales. For example, the total sales for this dataset is 280 and product 7 has sales as 70, which is why its contribution is listed as 25%. For the next one, we have a similar table and here we have to show the cumulative sum on the basis of date. So for 18th January, we should have 86 as output, which will be the sales of 17th January plus the sales of 18th January. For this one, instead of taking our cumulative sum just on the basis of date, we have to consider the products as well. So we should get 33 for product P1 on 18th Jan, which will be the sum of product P1 sales for 17th and 18th Jan. For the next one, we have a dataset showing the number of people impacted by a disease in three cities on a daily basis. We need to add a column showing the average number of cases for the day. For example, we have 25 cases for 14th Jan, which is why the average is shown as 8. Also, we need to show another column which depicts the average cases in the city in the last 7 days, excluding that particular day. For example, on 25th Jan 2021 for London, we should see the average of cases from 18th January to 24th January, which were reported in London, while for the row of 20th January 2021, we should see the average of cases from 13th to 19th January that were reported only in London. For the next one, we have to normalize the salary of our employees based on their department, designation, and the experience they have. So every employee will be compared with other employees from the same department on the same designation who have experience close to him. Here you have to calculate the average of salary based on designation and department, but you should consider only 6 employees immediately close to the person in terms of experience. For example, here for employee 4, you should take the average salary from employee 1 to employee 7 because they are closest to employee 4 in terms of experience. Similarly, for employee 5, you should take the average of these employees. For the next one, we have a table listing the quantity sold of a product on a daily basis and the forecasted sale for the next 3 days based on a particular model. This kind of analysis becomes really important for perishable goods with low shelf life or early expiry date, like bread. You want to make sure you are not creating too much so that it goes to waste. At the same time, you want to make sure you do not create too less, which will lead to stock out and customer going home empty handed. So here you have to calculate the actual sales that happened in the next 3 days and place it against your planned sales in a column like this, so that you can analyze the accuracy of your prediction. For the final one, you have a table listing the revenue from clients on a monthly basis. You want to add another column to your sheet which will list the maximum revenue earned from the client after the current month. For example, for January 2020, we can see that the maximum revenue was earned in May 2021, which was A21, so we should see that. While for May, which had a revenue of 821, we should see the revenue as 653, which is the highest revenue that we have earned from the client after May 2021. Try to solve these questions and post your answers in the comment section. If you have any doubts, do not worry. Just watch the next video where we will discuss rows, betweens, unbounded, following, current row, and everything you need to know about window and analytical function in detail.